So digestive symptoms ulcers. So that's also another pretty common illness. So what's the commonly if people got these kind of problems? So basically, it's chronic inflammations in the stomach and the dining room area. So dining room is the first part of small intestine. We know small intestine separate with three parts. So that's the first part of small intestine. So this area pretty easily got ulcers. So that's basically the ulcers happens in the mucosa membrane area. So when we're talking about the structure of digestive systems, we say the first layer is the mucosa membrane. And then we have some under mucosa membrane, like a connective tissue there. Then smooth muscles. Yes, smooth muscles, we have three layers there. Then outside cover. So that's generally for digestion tract anatomy structure. So most case for this kind of issue, they may only happens in the pretty superficial area, like a mucosa membrane there. But a truly severe case, they could go more deeper, go to the muscles or even through the muscles, and then penetrated whole digestive wall in there, like a stomach, small intestine. And they make a like open to the abdominal cavity. So that sometimes happens. So that kind of situation, if happens, that's a very severe kind of disorder, like an emergency kind of disorder. But most case, pretty superficial. So that's happens. Yeah, that happens. So we know stomach air inside the stomach. We have stomach acid. We have stomach acid and digestion juice. So normally, all digestion system, the tube, like a stomach and the small intestine, they have mucosa membrane protection there. So they are not truly damaged, like by stomach acid and the digestion acid. But for some reasons, like a stomach kind of weaker there, the stomach acid and the digestion acid will form the ulcers. So that's they say it happens. Yeah, it happens. Maybe in the stomach. If it happens in the stomach, we call gastro ulcer. But sometimes they may happen in the small intestine. When they happens in the small intestine, mostly in the first part of small intestine, we call dilute. So ulcers happens in the dilute. We call diurnal ulcer. So that's the general information about digestion system ulcer. So then we talk about the mainly symptoms. The mainly symptoms of peptic ulcers is burning kind of pain or pinching kind of pain. Like we just talked about, it's depending how severe of the ulcers is. And mainly happens in upper abdominal area. So we say upper abdominal area is the stomach and the diaphragm located area. So for our anatomy, we say we can separate abdominal area simply for four parts through the umbilicus and through the middle line. So that's the stomach physical location in here, yeah, physical location in here. And the diaphragm right in here. So that's basically happens in upper, especially on the left side. So that's left side. So like a patient's face to us. Yeah, patient's face to us. So that's the stomach. That's the diaphragm. So that's mainly painful in this eye. And it can be like a few minutes or even a few hours. So still depending how severe it is. And the diaphragm ulcers. So it typically pain can happen in the morning. Yeah, in the morning. And kind of relieves by eating. But recurrent happens about eating after 2 to 3 hours. So that in that case, sometimes patient be wake up because pain during the night. And symptoms. We're talking about the stomach ulcers. Eating may make it worse. So like we're talking about the painful situation. Stomach ulcers, when people eating, their stomach secretion more digestion juice, including stomach acid. So that make the painful more severe after eating. So that's the generally painful situation. Stomach ulcers after eating more painful. And the diaphragm ulcers, like the eating, make it a little bit better. And the other symptoms. We say mainly symptoms is stomach pain, but truly patient have other symptoms. Poor appetite, don't want to eat. Because when they eat, they feel more painful. And also sometimes nausea, vomiting. And also the ulcers like we say, depending damage, how deeper of the digestion void. If deeper, they may damage blood vessels, maybe cause the bleeding. So these kind of bleeding, sometimes if patient vomiting, they can vomiting out. But usually this kind of bleeding is not that big bleeding. So we talk about stomach bleeding. It could be coming from stomach illness itself. Like we talking about ulcers here. Certainly damaged blood vessel here, people can cause bleeding. But another severe kind of disorder, relationship of people vomiting with the blood is the liver issue. Psoriasis happens in the liver. Other words, hard liver. Hard liver blocking the blood flowing back to the heart. So they return back to the stomach circulation. We know stomach vein return go to the liver, portal vein. In liver getting harder, blood couldn't go to this way. They will go back to stomach. Cause the blood vessels, the vein dilate in the stomach eye. So in that kind of case, people vomiting with the blood could be pretty big amount and could be pretty dangerous situation. But usually stomach ulcers may not cause the bleeding. Even they cause the bleeding, usually it's a small amount. So generally say they don't damage big blood vessels. So that's bleeding can come out from people vomiting. And also, they can come out from the stool. Like the blood go down, follow the food, and the passing out coming from the stool. But generally speaking, they're coming out because the urine is a small amount. And they mix with stomach acid. So usually they are not like a fast red color. They kind of a coffee kind of color, like a dark brown color. If they pass in the stool, still dark color, or black color, dark brown color, or dark black color. So that's basically, because they mix with digestion juice. So that's stomach or small intestine bleeding. But if you truly see some people like a bowel movement with the blood in there, usually it's large intestine bleeding or arms bleeding. So that's upper digestive systems bleeding. They coming out with dark black color. So if patient long-term bleeding, long-term chronic bleeding, then can cause people anemia. Because we're talking about the balance of a red blood cell. Red blood cell living time, we know, last 120 days. That's the normal balance in there. The old red blood cell dies and the new red blood cell coming. Now they die less than 120 days or they lose it too much. People producing red blood cell, the speed is not a lot faster, couldn't catch up. So losing balance. So that's caused the anemia. Anemia generally say that's the illness. People red blood cell amount decrease and the hemoglobin inside of red blood cell decrease. So the problems, they couldn't send in enough oxygen to the tissues. Then people fatigue and generally weakness. So that's the generally symptoms of the ulcers in the stomach and the small intestine. Then we talk about how Western medicine can diagnose this illness. So for Western medicine diagnosis for this illness, certainly people have symptoms and signs. Like we talk about upper abdominal painful. Maybe eating make it worse. That's usually stomach ulcers. Maybe like an empty stomach worse. That's a small intestine ulcer. And the possible other symptoms we talked about. Maybe nausea, vomiting, and maybe some blood coming out from the nausea, vomiting. Or maybe blood in stool, but blood coming out in stool or coming out from vomiting is not truly red color because that blood mixes with digestion juice, especially stomach acid. So that is coming out like a dark coffee kind of color or even dark black color, depending how big amount of blood inside. And generally poor appetite, And maybe people always tired, fatigue. So like all the symptoms we talking before. And also possible anemia. So sometimes, people, they don't know they have stomach ulcers or small intestine ulcers. Like a pretty shallow in there. But that ulcers right over a blood vessel there. So they cause the continually bleeding there. But maybe people know symptoms like painful in abdominal area. They try to look in for the reason for anemia. Then they may find stomach or small intestine ulcers. So that's still possible, So that's the basically symptoms, relationship with stomach ulcers and the small intestine ulcers. So when people looking for treatment for the symptoms, they have symptoms. They go to GP, they go to family doctor. Then your doctors may give you more explanations, the checking with, like a laboratory test. for calculation for the blood and the hemoglobin, like inflammation, have anemia there. And spikely checking for digestion ulcers is X-ray, like before. Right now we have like a CT scan, MRI. But generally speaking, we need like a patient drink a special kind of liquid. This kind of liquid belong to mineral, barium, kind of metal. Kind of metal. So basically, when we're talking about X-ray, the X-ray, they can easily pass through for the air. So when they easily pass through for the air, we see the X-ray like a report there, or paper there, or picture there. So basically it's dark or black color. So all lung and stomach. There are truly more air inside. So even soft tissue, X-ray easily passing through. Still like black color, we can see it. So in that case, we couldn't see what happens inside of stomach. So this kind of metal ions or liquid there, barium, X-ray couldn't pass through. So like patient drink this kind of liquid first, then we can see. Like inside the stomach, normally that's the shape like this. But you can think about if they have some ulcers in somewhere. Then you can see like a black, a white color will go to like over the stomach eye. So that's the eye, ulcers eye. So that's the through, like take some barium first, then do X-ray. Then we can see truly the shape changing in the stomach eye and in the intestine eye. So that's some way we can diagnose it. And also the way we can make a diagnosis. Endoscope. What means endoscope? So basically put a scope that basically is a long tube kind of stuff from people's mouth or nose sometimes. This rule go down the esophagus to the stomach. In the height of this kind of scope, generally they have light in there. And then the doctors can see, like we have some open here. So truly we can see from here and then looking inside of stomach what happens. So that kind of scope is the endoscope. Pretty similar we hear the like a heart sound. We call that the scope. But this one go to inside the body. So sometimes this kind of gout, we can use to check in for stomach disorder. We also can check in for the lung disorder. So from the mouth or from nose, put the endoscope, go to the lung. Then we see if something blocking there or something like growth in there, like some tumor or cancer in there. Then we can see from outside. And even we can take pictures. So that's basically for Western medicine diagnosis. So treatment. So basically, we try to decrease the amount of the acid in the digestion, in the stomach. So we say acid, too much acid in the stomach, they possible damage like mucosa in the stomach, so we decrease it. And also histamine especially working for the receptors or for nervous system, blocking them. So the nervous systems stimulations stomach or digestion systems, producing more acid and maybe producing more acid. So when we block in there, so truly still decrease the secretion for stomach acid and acid. So that's we have some medications especially go to there. And people have stomach disorder, pay attention. Some other medications may make it worse, like aspirin. Aspirin is a pretty good medication right now. We say we can help thinner the blood and preventing for people angina kind of condition. But aspirin truly damaged the stomach and make stomach ulcers more worse. So if patient have stomach ulcers, they couldn't use aspirin. And maybe some other medication, if they say they can damage stomach mucosa membrane. So that's the Western medicine aspect. We talking about the symptoms and the treatment and the cause, the reason cause of stomach ulcers. So lot of reason, not truly clear. But truly relationship with the stomach acid, like an increase. Sometimes irregular eating can make a stomach ulcer. We're talking about our body, have a clock. Yeah. Our body truly have a clock. Like if your lifestyle is regularly, they will like you eating 3 meals a day. Till that time, it automatically secretes some stomach juice or acid to prepare for digestion food. But if your like lifestyle irregularly, like people don't have special time to eat, so your stomach is confused. They don't know when you need digestion juice to digest it. So they may like last day you're eating at 12 p.m. But today, until 3 p.m., you're still not eating yet. But your body thinking about 12 p.m. is the time you need eating, you need digestion. They will secrete the digestive juice and acid. Do not time. But do not time, you didn't eat it. Your stomach is empty. So long term, it's not only one time. Long term, they may damage your stomach mucosa membrane. So we need a changing lifestyle. Get regularly eating. So that's more important. And certainly, it's bad habit. Yeah. Don't drink too high degree kind of alcohol. Don't smoke. And not too stressful. So that's basically lot of reasons. Relationship with stomach ulcers. But the truly reason is not like a bacterial infection. Truly reason is still not that clear. And also people talking about a special kind of virus may be caused stomach ulcers also, even relationship with the stomach cancer. But still not truly clear yet. So that's why the medicine affected. Then we move into TCM part. So for the TCM, basically we name the illness by its symptoms. So if patient mainly stomach pain, then we name it Wei Wan Tong. Wei is stomach. Wan just like a holder there. Tong is painful. So like we talking about acupuncture points, we have 上腕, 中腕, 下腕. Just like a receiver or holder there. Yeah, 中腕 and 下腕. 上 is upper, 中 is middle, 下 is lower. But they still call one. So that's the 人跳. In the middle. So that's if patient mainly something. And if patients is like some burbling sounds in the stomach and maybe vomiting with the blood or maybe like just uncomfortable, it's not truly pain in there, but just uncomfortable in the stomach. We name it 嘈杂. 嘈杂 both like noise. Just means noise coming from the stomach. Noise coming from the stomach. So we still follow the symptoms. If patient truly vomiting of the blood, we can call 吐血. 吐 is vomiting. 吐 is vomiting. 血 is blood. If people bowel movement still have blood, we can call 便血. 便 is bowel movement, 血 is blood. So for Chinese illness name, basically we just follow the symptoms. For TTM, what caused the illness? We say internal damage, seven emotions. And also maybe relationship, irregular eating and drinking. So drinking less water, or maybe people drinking alcohol. Or maybe just the people weaker, yeah. Body weaker, like aging people. Their body generally weaker. Can cause lot of disease, not only some ulcers. So we're talking about these illnesses. Basically for TTM, we're thinking about more liver stomach discomfort. And then like liver qi stagnation, and then changing some qi. Liver qi stagnation attacking the middle gill, spleen, cause spleen qi deficiency. Spleen qi deficiency causes some damage and phlegm. And then spleen qi deficiency couldn't digest food properly, cause the food stagnation. And also some other reasons like yin deficiency, blood stasis, that may cause the problem. Then we go to different pattern. Yeah, we go to different pattern. We talk about different pattern, how we treat it with TTI, including the herbs, including the acupuncture. So we know for TTI, we treat the illness. We are not truly treat the illness. We treat by different pattern. Same illness, pattern difference, treatment is not different. Treatment is not the same. Different illness, if their pattern same, we treat with the same way. So that's especially for TTI. The first common pattern, liver stomach discomfort. So that's a pretty commonly pattern. So we still have the same symptoms, stomach pain, yeah, stomach pain, distending. And it may be worse by emotions. And people also can possibly have chest pain, and hypochondria pain, and distension, or maybe pressure. So that's basically the pattern. And maybe breaching or hiccup. And also possible poor appetite. Some people even more eating because they stress. When they stress, they just try to eat something. They put the food in the mouth, try to relieve stress. Some people have appetite. And if we're looking for the tongue, tongue, usually, if liver qi stagnation, changing to heat, may cause the dark right tongue, if liver qi stagnation, and then cause the blood stagnation, may cause the, like a dark pupil tongue. And could be white coating or maybe yellow coating, depending if they have heat or not heat. Bone spring pulse, the same. We're talking about the very pulse. So these book, they use both dream pulse, but the same like Yuli we're talking about, very powerful. So for this pattern, truly we need soothing the liver qi and harmonize middle jiao and stop. The formula we use, 四逆散闷类, working for soothing the liver, don't confusing 四逆散 with 四逆汤. We don't have too many formula, it's totally different. 散 and 汤, 散 is powder, 散 is powder. 汤 is decoction. Most of formulas, they should be the same ingredients inside. Yeah, they should be the same ingredients inside. But except 四逆散 and 四逆汤, yeah. That's totally different story. So here we use 四逆散. 四逆散门类 functions, soothing the liver. 四逆汤门类 functions is warming internally. So that's the formula with separate 散 and 汤. But the most formula, 散 and 汤 will be the same. And plus 金铃子散. Yeah, 金铃子散 still moving liver qi. And we need adding some other herbs. Yeah, adding some herbs like a stock pen. So that's like a yanhusuo here. Yanhusuo is pretty good herb to stock pen. We talking about that's TGM pinkator. So moving blood, resulting. And we have a lot of herbs moving qi, soothing the liver here. So that's basically for this. If we use acupuncture, we talk about zongwan here. Regular middle jiao and percutting six with three four together, still working for the stomach area, and generally spleen tonified, stomach 36 and the liver 3 for qi moving. Certainly you can combination with LFO together. That's usually we call four gates for qi moving. So that's we use. Then we talking about the pattern. Heat pattern. Liver qi stagnation, changing to heat. So that can development from last part. Stomach pain, intermittently. Sometimes happens, sometimes worse. Still emotions getting worse. People may have acid reflux. And the bitter taste in the mouth. So that's the heat sign. And the chest pressure, stomach distension, frequently bleaching, nausea, and still hypochondria pain. And people may have PMS. So post-menstrual breast distension and maybe with some emotions, that's the PMS. So that's the general symptom. And tongue, right tongue. And yellow tongue coating, mostly. Still very powerful. Heat pretty easily combination with dummy. Then people can have sleepy rapid talk. So treatment principle with soothing the liver and moving liver tea. This part especially have heat, we need clear heat. We still harmonize middle jaw because that's still mainly middle jaw problems in there. So the formula we use for this kind of condition, we use 逍遥散 and 左金丸. 逍遥散 is the formula, moving liver qi and harmonize middle jaw, spleen, stomach. Zhuojinwan mainly clear heat from the liver. So thus we put it together, treat this condition. Then we talk about for acupuncture. So for acupuncture, the points we still can use 人跳中脘 there, like harmonized middle jaw in there. And we still can use combination PC6 with 3-4. Confident points, the pair. Confident points, yeah. Especially regulating chest air and abdominal air. And stomach 36, we still can use 25 spleen stomach functions and severe kind of stomach pain. We can go to stomach 34. C collapsed points of the stomach. C collapsed points, we say, usually we can treat acute situation, especially painful situation. So that's we can use for these kind of conditions. Then we're talking about the next pattern, next common pattern. Spleen stomach deficiency kind of pattern. So still stomach pain, but mainly the painful happens like with empty stomach. Yeah. It's not that severe pain. Sometimes just hear some noise in the stomach area, but sore in there, uncomfortable in there. But after eating, let it be better. Especially eating some warm food. But usually, like sometimes, possible worst after. Yeah, totally. Like, especially eating uncooked food, cold food. So that's possible, yeah, possible, some situations. And the possible warming, yeah, possible warming. They warming with clear kind of water and the sour taste. And appetite decreased. Appetite decreased. No taste. Blunt taste means no taste in the mouth. So that's or lack of taste, basically the same meaning here. So that's the deficiency pattern, especially spleen qi deficiency. And then other symptoms, other symptoms, like a general fatigue, general fatigue, and generally weaker, and the possible cold hand, cold feet. So we say qi deficiency in severe case may cause yang deficiency. Pale face, usually we, white face, usually we mean pale face. Like losing moisture there, losing liquor there, and could be losing stool. Pale tongue. And the deficiency kind of pulse. So basically, that's the spleen stomach deficiency pattern. So treatment principle, we need a tonified spleen and the stomach. And warming the center. Warming the center, warming the middle jaw. This pattern we use xiang sha liu jun zi tang jia jie. Jia means plus, adding something. Jie means subtraction. Still the same meaning. Let's just give it the Chinese here, but the same meaning. So that's the mainly moving middle jiao qi and tonify spleen stomach qi formula. And you can modify from there. Like we still can add in, like yan hu su to stop painful situation in the stomach. Acupuncture, acupuncture, we still can use pretty similar points here. Like ren tiao, we can still can use stomach 36, we still can use. And we also can use some other points to tonify. The bladder 20, bacteria of the spleen, and also bladder 21, bacteria of the stomach. And the stomach 21, still regular stomach function there. So that's for this formula, Then we go to next pattern here. So kind of a blood deficiency, generally like a body deficiency pattern. So still noise coming from the stomach area, and especially stomach empty. You see, deficiency pattern, mainly relationship with empty stomach. And feel better after taking food. So that's our TCM deficiency pattern. Deficiency pattern, stomach pain, take food, make it better. excessive kind of pattern for TCM. Take food, make it work. So that's for TCM deficiency pattern. And the loose legs kind of face. And the pale limbs. And also patient possible have dizziness, palpitations in the heart, and the possible spontaneous sweating. That means qi deficiency. Yes, spontaneous sweating is qi deficiency. Night sweating is yin deficiency. And it's kind of not totally losing shen. It's kind of not that spirit, some down in there. And generally weaker, pale tongue. And the defensive pulse. So that's basically long-term defensive. This long-term qi blood defensive pretty possible coming, like people long term losing blood, like from the Bowman. So certainly we need tonified qi and tonified blood. The formula we use gui pi tang jia jie. Still the same meaning, adding some more herbs here. So gui pi tang is typically formula. We're talking about the tonified spleen and the tonified blood. And they also can come in shen, especially people have sleep problems. Yes, come in shen help people sleep. But we have a lot of herbs to tonify qi and tonify blood. So that's still qi tonified here. That's blood tonified here. And also have qi moving that we add in there. So that's herbs formula. Then acupuncture. Yeah, acupuncture, we use mainly blood tonify, back through of the blood, and the back through of the spleen, and the back through of the stomach. And the middle jaw regulating, generally qi blood tonify. Then the pattern for the stagnation, Food stagnation can cause the problems also. Still, lot of noise coming from the stomach. With some sore situation, and getting better after vomiting. That's excessive pattern. We say excessive pattern, vomiting, bowel movement, make it better. Defensive pattern, vomiting, bowel movement, make it worse. And take food, make it worse. That's excessive pattern. So vomiting, acid reflux, possible nausea, and don't like the smell of the food because they have food retention already. So stomach air is pretty full. Fall and distension. And possible some bad smell coming from the breathing. And also possible some bad smell coming from the stool. So tongue coating may be not changing. Tongue body may be not changing. But sometimes tongue coating may be greasy kind of tongue coating. Yeah, more moisty, more greasy. Possible normal. The pulse could be normal, could be sleepy pulse. So treat these problems. We remove food stagnations. So that's the formula we're talking about for Bao He Wan. Wan is health. Bao is like people overeating. They feel too full. He kind of harmonizes them. So basically, we have a lot of like help digestion herb inside, yeah, and moving tea. And the result flame. So that's the modified. Yeah, modified. So acupuncture, we still have Ren 12 and stomach 21, we talked about still harmonize the stomach there. And we also can use Ren 21. Yeah, Ren 21. So that's resolve some acid reflux in there. And stomach 36 still harmonize middle here. And also acupoise, and the bottom of the feet. Just opposite to stomach 43, I think it's 43 or 44. So inside, that part is we call knitting. That's inside a bottom of the feet. That's basically remove like a food stagnation. So like next part, we're talking about phlegm dummies, blocking the middle ear. Still noise coming from stomach. And also can have like a chest, abdominal kind of blocking there, pressure blocking there. And the appetite is reducing. May have phlegm, nausea, possible. Vomiting with some fluid, and the possible head distension. And people feel more heavy or like dull sensations, especially after eating, because they blocking inside. And slimy. The same meaning like a greasy tongue coating and a very flappy pulse. So that's basically more fluid blocking inside. So treatment principle, we still harmonize middle ear and the result phlegm. And the downward. The tuberate, yeah, phlegm is tuberate. So this one we use Bai Zhu Wan Jia Jing. So mainly result dummies under the phlegm. So thus we tonify the spleen functions. And also result phlegm, and put some digestion herbs inside, and clear some heat if they have. So the Points, yeah, the points we can combination with 人 12 人 13 together, yeah. That's still regular middle deal, still regular middle deal. And that's 3 1 together, yeah. 人 10, yeah, 人 12, 人 13, yeah. So regular middle deal. Still stronger regular middle deal. And the stomach 36 still tonified the spleen function. And the stomach 40 result phlegm. That's the result phlegm point. The next pattern we go to blood stasis. Blood stasis. Pattern. When we're talking about blood stasis, mainly if they cause pain, they will cause severe kind of pain. In the fixed location. And if they cause bleeding, like a vomiting bleeding or stool with bleeding, it's dark pupil kind of blood coming out. And the tongue, we can see the pupil color. And the pulse, choppy pulse, could be very pulse. So very pulse could come in from pain. So treatment principle, moving blood without phlegm and stop pain. So this one, we put a few formula together and modified. So 丹参饮, 金铃子散, and 石硝散. So mainly function, moving blood stop pain. So that's the problem. And the acupoints, yeah, acupoints. We still middle jaw regulating. And then we go to some points, moving blood. Bladder 13. Certainly, you also can go to spleen 10. Moving blood. And the next part is stomach indifference. Basically, indifference cause dry, yeah, dry lips, dry mouth. And with some acid refluxing, hiccup, vomiting, and some burning sensation in the stomach. People may more hungry. But they don't like eating too much. And they will constipation with dry food. Dry tongue without coating. Or maybe no coating. Mild tongue. Lightly coating or no coating. Thin rapid pulse. So the formula we use, Maimen Dong Tang, nourishing stomach yin, harmonize the stomach. The acupoints, yeah, acupoints. Oh, Neiting stomach 44. We talked about Li Neiting before, yeah. Opposite for stomach 44. And still harmonize middle jaw, still harmonize middle jaw. But we need some nourishing points here. So that's basically we talk here about digestion systems, ulcers. So that's basically provides the medicine, sometimes they make combination is bacterial infections, maybe use some like antibiotics, and also can use some like a calcium kind of medications in TCM can reduce kind of RC producing. And the important part, keep the food. Yeah, keep the food. That's more important part. And don't drink alcohol. Don't eat too hot food. No spicy food. No greasy food. Not too fatty food. So that's basically, and the treatment, we can use combination with vice medicine and with TCM. Help each other, or sometimes can reducing the side effects of vice medicine. And even make vice medicine treatment more effective. If we combination vice medicine with the TCM treatment at the same time.